You know, sitting around talking about cars and motorcycles is what I do to relax with my mates. So to get the chance to come here today and meet these four incredible people and just talk about my favourite hobby in the world, I'm really looking forward to it. Having that genuine connection, it's going to be great because the one thing we've got in common is a love of motorcycles and a love of motorcycle racing. So I'm pretty excited. I actually can't get my head around it yet. Loris Caparossi, I mean, absolute legend. It's so important to have someone that used to be a rider being the guy that's talking to the riders about safety and what they've done wrong during a race and imposing penalties, anything like that. I have vivid memories of him racing here on the Ducati, and it was just great to ask him, you know, what the hell was going on with that bike. Combination of you and that bike coming out of turn 12 always looked like you were going to get thrown off that thing.
Yeah, like a crazy bull, you know?
It was just moving.
I fighting always with that bike, you know?
That's someone who, it's in his blood, and that's just who he is, and it's not going anywhere. There's no such thing as hanging up the helmet for someone like him.
I have a really strong passion about two-stroke bike.
Yeah.
Because I love the smell of the oil, you know, the engine, the sound.
Yeah.
Maybe one time I want to ride with you with
okay.
the bike.
Yeah,
and
sure.
We can learn together,
can learn,
you know?
Stuff.
When you have a passion about motorcycle or the car, also you jump on a car like that, you say, wow, it's easy, it's nice, you know?
Yeah.
Because for sure, you jump on MotoGP bike, you can drive. You can ride, sure. Yeah, easy, you can ride easy. And you can go quickly.
Can't believe I'm going to get to meet Valentino Rossi. To get to meet him whilst he's still on the front row of the grid is just a huge thrill. What's it like on these bikes coming onto the main straight? Because you've got that much power, how you manage to still steer the bike when the front's coming up?
Yeah, I think the exit from the last corner is one of the more impressive if you look from outside. Mm-hmm. Because when we open the throttle, it's a fourth gear, but we put on the ground 250 horsepower and it's impressive.
You definitely get a sense that he's having a lot of fun. Like, he is still like a big kid, you know, and it's just so genuine with him. How did you find the rallying when you...
I think a rally is something different, no, compared to the other motorsport. And you need time, you need kilometers, because you have to think, but you have also to follow.
And the relationship with the actual navigator, the same person every time.
You need to trust in him 100%.
Yeah.
So for I feel better on the track.
Yeah.
Because I'm growing up in the track.
You love driving the cars too, right?
Yeah, I like a lot. I growing up racing with a go-kart when I was very, very young. So supposed to become a car driver.
Right.
Yeah, but fortunately, after I decided for the motorcycle, and I think it was the right decision.
I think so. And now to meet the guy who's responsible for the shape of MotoGP in 2016, hearing him talk about, you know, growing up and being around the smells of two-stroke and how much that reminded him of his childhood.
My passion for motorsport has been since I was 5 years old.
Mm-hmm. So did your passion for motor racing come from your father, or was it something that just was your own as a kid? Or
for me, I started because the noise and the smell of the oil.
Right.
Was something special, you know. When I was maybe 15 or something like that, I knew all the motorbikes, all the cars model, which is the difference, how much cost. What
people
is that?
Think you're mad because you can close your eyes and go, it's a Honda,
it's a Suzuki.
Really excited to meet Maverick. I mean, he's obviously been a standout young talent this year, and you know, for a 20-year-old guy, he just seems so comfortable. I mean, I think back to when I was 20, I would have been freaking out. So what's it like growing up, seeing all your idols, and then next minute you're on the grid, you're racing with them, you're starting to beat them?
For me, that is awesome, you know, when you are a kid and you see your idol, know the level that he is, and now when you look back, you are there. That's an incredible feeling, you know.
So where did you start, Maverick? Was it dirt for you? What was your entry point?
The entry point was when I was 3 years old. And the passion comes from the family, you know.
What were you wearing when you were 3 years old on a motorbike?
Normally the normal clothes with small gloves, because you don't have any clothes.
Starting racing at age 3 is the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard. He's got a real spark in his eye. I saw him when we were talking, him looking at his bike. You could actually see he just can't wait to get on that thing tomorrow. It was really nice for me to have that genuine connection with people. Just a, you know, really special day, really memorable, and yeah, won't be forgetting that one in a hurry.